Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be a tutorial on this look right here. It's just a pretty sparkly cut crease, and prom is right around the corner, so I figured anybody that was going could use this as a prom look. I would definitely rock this. So we are just going to get started, and don't judge me, please. I'm just going to add a little bit of Tarte Shape Tape all over my lids to prime, and some tape on the edges so I can get a nice sharp edge there. And I'm going to move on to brows. This is ColourPop's brow pencil, and I'm not sure the shade. I think it's brunette. I'll leave all the shade names and products below as I always do. And a little trick that I like to use is just taking a little angled brush and going straight from the pencil and using that to fill in the front of your brow because it makes it look a little bit more natural. For the eyeshadow, I'm going to be playing with the new Urban Decay Naked Reloaded palette, which I'm not that crazy about the colors in this palette, but I am absolutely in love with the packaging. It's seriously that cute. The texture, the print, oh my god, it's just on point. I'm starting with a shade called Bucked, which I believe is an original shade. Or maybe that's Buck. I don't know. Anyways, I'm putting that all in the crease, just kind of messily blowing it out from the inner corner to the outer corner. Then I'm gonna take the lightest shade in the palette called Bribe, and I'm gonna apply that under the brow bone as a highlight shade. This is a stunning highlight shade. It's not overpowering. It's not too sparkly or glittery. It's just the perfect little sheen. Ugh, I love it. Then I'm going to deepen up that crease with the shade called Endgame, which is a more cool toned neutral brown, and I'm taking that on a smaller fluffy brush and just hugging that on the outer V area. I took whatever was left on my brush and brought it into the inner corner. I didn't want that to be as dark in the beginning, but I did eventually go back and make it a little bit darker so the cut crease would stand out a little bit more, so I kind of regret that. I wish I went a little heavier with the Endgame shade, but oh well. So now I'm just going to blend that out with the first fluffy brush, make sure that it's nice and seamless. Then I'm going to cut the crease again with Tarte Shape Tape. So I'm just using a small concealer brush, and I'm going to apply some of the concealer on the lash line, then look straight up, and that's going to give me the top of my cut crease. And then you can just drag the concealer down, and there you go. This is a great trick for people who have hooded eyes so that you know exactly where you're supposed to bring that concealer up to, because it can be tricky when your crease and your cut crease are not the exact same line, if that makes sense, like mine. And then I'm just taking the remaining concealer on that brush and using dragging motions to blend it in to the outer V. So it's not a full-blown cut crease because I didn't bring it all the way over to the tape, but I just wanted to keep it a half cut crease because it's a little bit more soft and wearable. So now I'm just taking the shade Angel Fire and packing that all over the lid, leaving a little bit of space on the outer third just for another color. And then I'm taking Endgame, like I said in the beginning, I went back and deepened it up just the outer corner there. And now I'm applying the shade Burn, and it's going in the little space that we left between Endgame and Angel Fire. And I'm just going to be blending those into the two. It's a beautiful rusty copper shade, so I just thought it would bring some dimension to the lid. And I'm just using tiny swiping motions and really meshing those two colors together to get a nice gradient. And then I'm going back once again with Endgame on a really tiny pencil brush and just deepening up that crease. Otherwise, the glitter that we're gonna put on wouldn't stand out as much. So the darker that you go with your crease color, the lighter that your lid is going to appear. So at that point, it's just personal preference. I kind of like how soft this one turned out. It's not like a full-blown pink glitter cut crease that's really dark and bold, you know what I mean? But if that's your cup of pudding, then girl, I fully support you. So now I'm just going in with liner, and I am gonna do a wing, but it's gonna be the most simple, thin, non-in-your-face wing that I could possibly do. And I started out using Makeup Revolution's liner, and it just wasn't really doing it for me. It wasn't as dark as I wanted it, and it was kind of hard to use. So I switched over to the NYX liquid liner, and I just did the damn thing. So reveal your masterpiece, and then what I like to do is take my finger and kind of smudge the edges, because I don't really want it to look like I used tape. I want it to look like my precision is just that good, you know? Okay, finally, now we're moving to the face. I'm using the Sleek Makeup Hydrating Primer and just dotting that all over, rubbing it in. You know how to put primer on. Then for foundation, I'm going in with the new Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation Stick. This is in the shade Soft Ivory, which I was wearing self-tan this day, and I think that that was the darkest shade they sent me, so I just had to roll with it and make it work. They normally send me my right shade. It's just I was self-tanned, and I'm not normally self-tanned because, as you can tell by my hands, I don't know how to apply it for shit, but I'm gonna keep trying because I like being tan. But anyways, back to the foundation. I'm not normally a stick foundation fan, but I actually really enjoyed this formula. It didn't cling to any of my dry spots, which is usually what happens with stick foundations. It was definitely more on the hydrating side more than any of the other stick foundations that I've tried. So for the price, then it's drugstore and cruelty free. This is a great foundation, and I'm just taking it on a little concealer brush to get around my brows and other areas. But yeah, my skin looked really dewy. It's a medium to buildable coverage. You could definitely see through it, but if you needed to add more coverage to spots, you could definitely do that. So I really liked it. Now moving on, I'm taking the NYX Cream Contour Palette and a little bit of Urban Urban Decay's facial oil drops just to make it a little bit more creamy and easier to blend. And I'm taking that on a brush and putting that in the hollows of my cheeks and more so just around the perimeters of my face just to give me some color back into my face since that foundation was a little bit light. I'm just gonna try to look somewhat congruent with my body color. Congruent? Is that the right word? I don't know. Anyways, I'm gonna put that on my forehead, the temples, gonna go pretty heavy. I don't even know what color I am. I mean, my hands are 80 different shades of white and tan and orange, so we're gonna try to go for that look, I guess. I'm also gonna take that on my chin just to, you know, match, and a little bit down the side of my nose just for a nice touch. Concealer time. So now I'm going to apply Makeup Revolution. Yes, Makeup Revolution. And it was a little bit too dark, I think. I don't know. It really probably wasn't. I shouldn't have added this. But I'm gonna go in with a super light concealer from Tarte because I cannot go a day in my makeup routine without using Shape Tape. It honestly scares me. I don't know what's gonna happen if I do. I say the dumbest shit ever. Okay, so now I'm going to bake. Well, it's not really baking. I'm just going to set the under eyes with a little bit of the Derma Blend powder and a sponge that's damp. I really like this method. It really just presses the powder into the skin. It looks super, super pretty, especially if you have dry, flaky skin, to try this method to get a really damp sponge and press your powder in, because the moisture in the sponge is going into the powder as it's setting. So it just helps with eliminating that cakiness. So definitely give that a try if you're on the drier side. So now I'm just taking a big fluffy brush and dusting away any of the excess, and then going in with some bronzer. This is the Wet n Wild Color Icon Bronzer in Sunset Striptease. Ooh. And I'm just taking that on an angled fluffy brush and going over that cream contour, just darkening it up a little bit and setting it down, just bringing out that sun-kissed striptease color. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. I hate myself. I'm going to go in with some black eyeliner. This is by Sleek, and that's going on the waterline. I'm only taking it halfway, and then I'm taking a brush and blending that out just to make it nice and smoky. And then I'm taking a bigger fluffy brush with, I believe, Endgame on it. Yes, Endgame. And I'm going to blend that out even more, make it even more smoky, and have a nice gradient from black to brown. Then I'm going to go ahead and add some false lashes. Can't remember the style off the top of my head, but I will leave that info down in the down bar. And then I'm taking some Hourglass mascara. This is the Caution mascara. Really, really love it. And I'm just coating my lashes with that. Then going back to the face, I'm taking Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette. I have not used this in ages, and I forgot how much I love it. It's the perfect contour shade. So I'm just putting that in the hollows of my cheek. Whoa, this is going fast. Now I'm taking this cute little rose brush from the Wet n Wild. I think it's a limited edition rose collection. It's such a cute brush. I don't think I'm ever going to use it again for makeup because it's just too cute, and I like it in its packaging just set up in my beauty room. So this is its debut and its one and only time being touched on a human face. So enjoy this, ladies and gentlemen. It did work really good, but it's too pretty. And I liked the blush as well. It was a pretty coral shade, and that was from Profusion Makeup, which I've never tried before, but they sent me over some makeup, and I think it's a really affordable brand. And yeah, I really liked that makeup. I just clapped. But now I'm going to apply highlighter. This is the Balm Mary Luminizer, an oldie but a goodie. Still one of my absolute favorites. So I'm just drenching the high points of my face in that, and then taking a brush and blending it out just to make sure that it looks nice and skin-like and not just a highlighter on top of the skin, you know? And I'm also gonna pop that in the inner corners as well. And then I'm gonna set my brows with a little bit of Anastasia Brow Gel, and I like to save this for the last step of my makeup just because if I set them right after I do my brows in the beginning and then I take a big fluffy brush and try to blend out my bronzer on my temples, it's gonna mess them up. So I got a little smart and I just started setting my eyebrows towards the end when I was done blending my face makeup. So now I'm gonna line the lips. I'm using the Balm's lip liner in the shade Chemistry, and then I'm gonna go over that with a liquid lipstick by Mellow Cosmetics in the shade Milan. This eye makeup is really universal, so you could have worn a red lip or a dark lip or a nude, but I just wanted to wear a pretty medium pink just because I don't wear this shade that often and I wanted to do something new. So now I'm just going to set it all in place with some Wet n Wild cucumber setting spray. Oh, it smells so good. I love cucumber. And that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and maybe found some inspiration for a prom look. You could always swap out the color glitter for whatever your dress is. So I think it would be really pretty. Let me know if you guys use it, and I will see you guys in my next video. I love you. Mwah.